History of dermatology. Vitiligo and leprosy. Hypolinosis conditions are known since ancient times. The most ancient names to describe these pictures were Shvetakushta and Sudra. The term Shvetakushta, in the book Atharvaveda of the 15th century before Christ, can be translated literally as white, Shvetakushta, leprosy, Kushta, while the term Sudra is found in the Manusmriti, a work of Hindu law and ancient Indian society. The vitiligo has long been confused with the leprosy and with other leukoderma diseases, therefore the Hebrew word Zara or Zerat Zarath was translated using the Greek word lepros and the Latin word lepra. There is a well-known example in the Old Testament. Naaman, captain of the hosts of the king of Syria, suffering from psoriasis, Russell 1950, on the advice of Elisha, washed 7 times in the Jordan to rid himself of Zarath. The ancient Greek writers divided cutaneous diseases into 3 classes, Zara, Lepra, and Lichen. The leprosy was also known to the Greeks under the name Elephantiasis Graecorum, but in the early Middle Ages when the Arabic texts were being translated into Latin, the translators confused Lepra Graecorum with Elephantiasis Graecorum, making understand that all scaly conditions of the skin were due to the leprosy. Therefore, to describe the true leprosy was introduced the term Lepra Arabum. The term vitiligo has been derived instead from the Latin word vitellus and was coined by Olaus Cornelius Celsus, approximately 25 before Christ. 50 in his work, De Medicina. During all the early Middle Ages there is again a complete identification between hypomelanosis and leprosy, and only in the early 800, 1832, in the work of dermatology of Baron Alibert, the picture of vitiligo is clarified definitively. Abstract. Professor Camillo DiCicco, M.D., American Association for the History of Medicine.